This bag one image is perhaps John's most famous drawing and has become the universal logo for the Lennon estate. It is a reflection of his relationship with his wife, Yoko.
I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Lynne Clifford, and I'm the director of Bag One Arts.
John completed the original Bag One portfolio as a wedding gift for Yoko in 1969. The portfolio contained 14 sketches, which were depictions of their wedding ceremony and honeymoon in Montreal and Paris. Included in the portfolio were several rather intimate and erotic drawings. John and Yoko realized that their wedding, the marriage of a former Beatle to an avant-garde Japanese artist, would become a major media event. They decided to use their marriage and the press coverage it would receive to make a political statement.
It's a bed-in, folks.
Their Montreal bed-in for peace became a huge media event, a happening.
One, two, three, four.
In a time of protest and demonstration over the Vietnam War, with riots happening in cities and on campuses across the country, their bed-in was John and Yoko's way of showing the world a nonviolent way to protest. Many of the drawings contained in the original portfolio and in our series entitled Bag One Continued are a celebration of these events. The first exhibition of John's lithographs took place in London in 1970. The works attracted a large audience of celebrities, art lovers, fans, and those curious about John's work. It also brought the police. The show was considered obscene because of the graphic nature of the erotic drawings. Because of this fact, the prints were confiscated, destroying much of the artwork in the process. The same fate would befall the shows in Montreal and Chicago later that year. John was considered by many to be a true Renaissance man. In addition to composing music, he wrote and illustrated three books. In 1968, a play based on excerpts from his first two books, In His Own Right and A Spaniard in the Works, opened at the National Theatre Company in London and was well received by both the audience and the critics. In the early 1970s, he collaborated with Yoko in the making of several experimental films, such as Fly. But in the end, he would always come back to art. Art was actually his first love.
Long before I was a pop artist, or even a Beatle, or before I had a guitar. So it's nothing to do with that. The guitars came second.
Second. And which comes first?
Well, now the guitars come first, because this is still a hobby, which it always has been.
From 1957 to 1960, John attended one of the finest art schools in England, the Liverpool Art Institute. John sketched in pencil, pen, or Sumi ink. As the program gained in popularity, we were constantly asked if we intended to produce any color editions. John and Yoko collaborated in all things during their life together.
How about the company that you and Yono have formed, this bag,
Yoko.
Bag production?
Yoko Productions is what takes care of our business, you know, that's books, films, and records.
Well, now you see, John and Yoko is a team, you see, and we're doing it together.
Her choice of the shades used in the color renditions is a continuation of that bond. She personally hand-colored the renditions from which the printer achieved the desired effect within each color print. Each print you'll see is hand-signed by Yoko Ono Lennon. A signature appears beneath the pencil number in the lower left-hand corner, with John's embossed signature in the lower right. Directly next to, or slightly below the signature, is John's red chop mark. In the Orient, artists sign their works with their chop. No two are the same. They are a patented, registered trademark. John designed his himself. The Japanese characters read, like a cloud, beautiful sound. The creation of this program in 1986 was the fulfillment of Yoko's silent promise to John to share his artwork with the world. The first collection of prints, This Is My Story, Both Humble and True, consists of 5 shin clay editions, 12 black and white serigraphs, and 5 color serigraphs. The 5 shin clay images were selected from the original Bag One portfolio. The shin clay technique is stone lithography on Japanese rice paper adhered to Stonehenge paper. The image is first etched on limestone and then pressed onto the rice paper. The first image, Bag One, is considered the universal logo of John and Yoko's estate. It represents the unity of man and woman solidified in their movement together. In the drawing I do, John has recreated their wedding ceremony. Standing before the judge in Gibraltar on March 29, 1969, they exchanged their wedding vows. The honeymoon shows them rushing through the airport with their bags en route to Paris. With the sketch John and Yoko, he is once again depicting their togetherness. In John's eyes, they are two minds attached, thinking as one. The last shin clay print, Bed In for Peace, is considered to be one of the most important pieces in this series since it is a recreation of John and Yoko's commitment to world peace. The first of the 12 silkscreen editions in This Is My Story, Both Humble and True, is on the telephone with family. Here we find Yoko on the phone, taking care of business, while John looks after Sean. This is the role he chose for himself after his son's birth. He felt Sean was his most important creation, and he became his first concern in life. In looking back, we see John holding up a mirror to his face. The man holding the mirror has aged, is more seasoned and self-assured. Looking back at him is a younger self, the inner feelings of youth still within his eyes. Again, John's drawing reveals his feelings about himself and man in general. Have I accomplished enough in the time allotted me? It's Only Rock and Roll is John's personal salute to 2 rock and roll greats, Elvis Presley and Elton John. He draws Elvis as an aging, overweight superstar who is still able to elicit the love of his fans and bring them to a frenzy. There is a dedication within the drawing to Elton John. The guitar is Benny, and the Jets are the audience. Morning Coffee was drawn in Japan in 1977. It enacts the start of Yoko's busy workday. John was separated from Yoko for a year, and the exile was drawn during that period. His feelings of being lost and alone in the desert, the solitude, all these emotions are evident in the dress of a nomad, banished, wandering in search of his past and future. The family is a weaving of 3 faces, John, Sean, and Yoko. The lines flow uniformly into one another, symbolizing their unity. In its original form, this drawing was a signature taken from the bottom of a letter. Look closely and notice atop John's head is his signature with kisses. The sketch, Visit to Japan, shows the Lennons on a trip to Japan in 1977. The calligraphy on the side translates, The Ono Lennons, Let's Dream. With Baby Gran, we find John composing at his famous white piano in their living room at the Dakota. The joy he feels from the creation of his music is depicted by the notes issuing forth from the flowers. He loved nature and associated the opening of each petal with his growth, both in music and art. Here we find John and Yoko entwined as one figure, no beginning, no end. In this sketch called The Hug, John depicts the two of them as a childlike couple, naive and content. In The Whole of My Life flashed before me, John is looking through a black hole in astonishment as he sees his life passing before him. It is a reflection of a void that needs to be filled at some point in everyone's life, no matter how successful and secure they may be. In An Apple Pie Bed, John has combined 2 themes. Apple was the record label the Beatles recorded under. After their breakup, John brought Yoko into his apple pie bed as an integral part of both his business and life. They've also achieved the great American dream of being home, safe and secure in each other's arms. In the sketch Back Off Boogaloo, John once again draws himself in a paper bag. He travels across the prairie like an American cowboy, alone with just his horse and a cactus. Outside the bag, the sun is shining. John has been summoned back by Yoko. He foresees much happiness in the future. Once upon a time, there were no problems, is John's reflection of what life is like for his infant son, Sean. What life is like for any newborn who is cared for and nurtured, who has not yet started on the rocky path towards his dreams. In the whimsical sketch Kangaroo, the pouch represents the establishment. The people are jumping out of the pouch, running away from the strict regulations imposed upon them by society. The people are running in opposite directions, all voicing their own opinion. With the suitors, John shares his belief that every man hides behind a mask when he speaks to a woman. He may court her with flowers and sweet words, but even when he loves her, he manages never to tell her the truth. It is the woman, John says, who must remove the mask and determine which suitor will make the best mate. The Embrace was created in 1969 and depicts John and Yoko kissing and embracing. The drawing represents his feeling of love, respect, and security between them. The last print in the series, This Is My Story, Both Humble and True, is called Family Tree. Here, John and Yoko are sitting beneath a tree, contemplating their future, dreaming, peaceful and content. Above them lies the golden apple of temptation, the test of life we all must face. The next series, Bag One Continued, is a continuation of the Bag One portfolio. It consists of 5 serigraphs and 2 copper etchings. The original 2-is-1 and real love drawings were done in Sumi ink. In order to recreate the brushstrokes, we elected to produce them as copper etchings. 2-is-1 is an aquatint with a hand-rolled blue background. It is one of the 7 images drawn for the original Bag One portfolio, but not included in the suite. Once again, John and Yoko are side by side, always one. Real Love, the second copper etching, is a portrait of John and Yoko entwined in each other's arms. In Peace and Love, and We Made Our Bed, we are back with John and Yoko at the Bed Inn for Peace in Montreal. In Peace and Love, they discuss their hope for world peace, and in We Made Our Bed, John is playing the sitar with Yoko at his side.
What's baggage?
What's baggage?
Okay, that's right. It's a, I don't know what they call it, like a newspaper, a tag for what we all do. We're all in a bag, you know, and we realize that we came from 2 bags. You know, I was in this pop band bag going round and round in my little clique, you know, and she was in her little avant-garde clique going round and round, and you're in your little telly clique, and they're in the, you know, and we all sort of come out and look at each other now and then, but we don't communicate, and we all intellectualize about it. There's no barrier between art, music, poetry, but we're still all, I'm a rock and roller, he's a poet. It's amazing. We did a press conference in Vienna, and they're pretty square over there.
And they all got in the bag?
No, we were in the bag that time. And all the press came in, sort of expecting Beatle John and his famous wife, and we were in the bag singing and humming, and all they were asking is, what are you wearing? It was great. And they're all sort of holding mics to this bag, you know, and asking it how it felt, and was it glad to be here?
The Ballad of John and Yoko is a sketch of how they appeared on their wedding day. The final sketch from Bag One Continued is the Eiffel Tower. Here we see John and Yoko standing in front of the Paris landmark on their honeymoon. The 5 multicolored serigraphs and copper etchings in the last series, The Dakota Days, are taken from the sketches John did shortly before his death. In Nothing is Impossible, John is walking on water. It was done during a very happy time in his life. John felt so good, he thought he could achieve anything. Here we see John and Sean walking through Central Park, John holding Sean's hand, the loving father spending time with his son. They are stopped by a fan, and John offers him, "Peace, brother," and that's the title of this piece. In Feeling Good, John once again exhibits his whimsical sense of humor. He draws himself levitating outside of himself, feeling happy, just feeling good. Watch the Holes, Yoko is a very loving, sensitive drawing of John holding Yoko's hand, guiding her through the pitfalls of life, always by her side, watching out for her. The last print in this series, entitled Beautiful Boy, is a portrait of Sean when he was an infant, done in copper etching combined with serigraphy. Along with the print editions, we released a series of kinetic neons. They are an interpretation of John's sketches in the neon medium. The company who produces these neons is the only company in the world holding a patent whereby the gas travels through the neon. There are three separate gases within the hand-blown glass that animate the images. None of the pieces contain any mercury, so there is no danger in case of accidental breakage. The speed the gases travel can be regulated by a control in the back of each unit, or they can be left stationary. In commemoration of the 50th year of John Lennon's birth, Bagwan Arts has continued This Is My Story, Both Humble and True, by publishing Chapter 2 of John's sketchbook. Once again, we are provided with a glimpse into the personal lives of the Ono Lennons through John's art. Drawn in 1977, Borrowed Time recreates John at his piano. The up-tempo of the music is evident in the look on his face, his hair on end from the excitement and pounding rhythm. John's caption on this piece reads, "And then I was suddenly 38. The look of bewilderment can be seen on his face. He has arrived at the ripe age of 38, musing to himself, how did I get here, and where did the time fly?" In every day, in every way, once again, John has penned a message within the drawing. Every day, in every way, I'm getting better. Sketched in 1979, we see John looking at a mirror image of himself, with the trace of a smile on his face. He's pleased with life. John's incredible sense of whimsy can be seen again in the intimate portrait, Two Virgins, in which John and Yoko are seen eating bananas. This print is reminiscent of the cover photograph which appeared on the jacket of their Two Virgins LP record. The original was done in 1969. One Day at a Time shows a jogger running through Central Park, who turns in flight to wave at John and Yoko. One of the Lennons' favorite pastimes was to walk through Central Park. They spent many happy hours there. This was one of the reasons Yoko dedicated Strawberry Fields to the many people who greeted them there with such devotion. The drawings included in the Carrizoa series segment of the program were all created in 1977 during a trip the Lennons made to Carrizoa, a city in Japan. In the first print, Carrizoa 77, John is reclining on a tatami mat while he enjoys the pleasures of a massage. His glasses lie on the floor within hand's reach. This next image, the first one, carries an inscription on the original sketch. To Yoko, the first one. She would always occupy the first place in John's heart. In Tokyo, summer 77, the closeness of the family is captured. The image recalls an outing with Yoko, Sean, and John. Sean is poised between his loving parents while the breeze catches his balloon. This set of silkscreen photographs are dedicated to the memory of John Winston Lennon, one of the most important cultural figures of our time. All of these graphic works celebrate human love and communication, two themes at the heart of John Lennon's contribution to the art of the 20th century. To quote John, "If art were to redeem man, it could do so only by saving him from the seriousness of life and restoring him to an unexpected boyishness." The final prints in our series is the Imagine Suite called Self-Portrait. It is a suite of four hand-pulled serigraphs reflecting the passing of the seasons. The suite is packaged in a black portfolio with John's embossed signature in gold. The edition is printed on Arches paper, and the edition size is 150 pieces.